Thank you. Tonight, so we'd like to welcome everybody that's here in Westbrook Music Hall and or Recital Hall, and everybody that's out there in the ether as well. We are the UNL Faculty Jazz Ensemble. We open up with a piece by Darryl White called A Chord of Three Strands. Wasn't that a great tune? I've been trying to get Darryl to bring in some of his original material for a couple years now, and I found some pictures. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh.
Joe, bad joke. Finally got to bring in one of his tunes, so hopefully there will be more. We're going to continue with a song by a saxophone player named Jerry Bergonzi. Now, he's not a really well-known name outside of jazz circles, but in the jazz world, he is known as, let me just put it this way, Michael Brecker, before he died, said that, referring to himself, he said, "I am the second best saxophone player in the world. Jerry Bergonzi is the best." And so this tune, the Grammy winner, is what we call a contrafact. It's a, we took an existing, or Jerry Bergonzi took an existing tune and put a new melody on it, or a new head, as we call it. So I won't tell you what the existing tune was. The new head that's on this is so whacked out, it's not even close to the original melody. But it's very interesting. So after we get done with this, I'm going to ask some of you jazz musicians in the audience, I'll ask and see if you recognize what the tune is. So this is A Grammy Winner by Jerry Bergonzi.
Thank you.
Thank you.
continue with a song that I wrote called Last Flight, and this is sort of an interesting tune because it has sort of a chamber jazz quality to it, which a lot of times we associate with sort of a classical, quote-unquote, type of sound. But yet there's a lot of blues elements in it as well, and so there's sort of a dichotomy there. The solo section is fairly open, and so the soloist, who is soloing this?
Hans Peter Darryl,
HPD. they've got some leeway to sort of choose between if they're going to follow the changes or if they're going to just put some more blues elements into it. So it, so there's some freedom in the solos in that respect as well. So this is Last Flight.
Thank you.
In my job here at the Glenn Clark School of Music as assistant professor of composition, I get to work with a lot of very fine young composers, and we're going to play a piece by one of my students. And Andrew Janak is actually not here at the moment. He is over at NET helping with the webcast. So, hi Andrew, wherever you are. He brought this into a lesson very early on in the semester, and I knew that this was going to be just a perfect tune for this band to play. And it's a very beautiful tune that has a couple of rhythmic changes in it, but it's called Impaired Judgment. Andrew Janak.
Thank you.
Darryl White on trumpet. On drums, Dave Hall. On bass, we have Hans Sturm. And our fearless leader on saxophone and just saxophones tonight, Paul Haar. And my name is Tom Larson. Play a couple more tunes. This next tune is a Wayne Shorter original. We've got three saxophone composers tonight, Bergonzi, Janak, and
Shorter.
So this is a tune by Wayne Shorter. This was arranged by a former member of this group. Sometimes it seems like people come and go so quickly in this group. This was arranged by Dr. Eric Richards, who used to be the trombone player and so wrote many of the compositions and arrangements for this group. But this is called United.
Thank you.
tune that we're going to play tonight. We'd like to thank everybody for coming out and everybody out in the ether land is watching. We have a few things coming up in the UNL Plainport School of Music jazz program. It's coming Monday. We have a concert by world-renowned saxophone composer John Ellis in this very room, right? In Westbrook Recital Hall. And then it's on December 10th. December 10th, the Jazz Orchestra and Big Band will be performing at Kimball Hall. And that is a tribute to the Big Bands, right?
Yep.
The Masters. So that's going to be something to look forward to. Our final piece was another one of my original compositions. This was inspired in part by back in the 70s. I was a big fan of a group from England called King Crimson, and King Crimson fans, anybody?
Oh yeah.
It's a small but very loyal fan base, but I actually got to see them down in Kansas City. They were very good at doing they played kind of classical rock. Some people call them an art rock band or a progressive rock band, but they mastered this thing which I call controlled violence. And I've been intrigued with that ever since. And so this tune was in part inspired by them, and in part inspired by fighter Ronda Rousey. Now, if you don't know who Ronda is, look her up online after the concert. You can watch her last three fights. It'll take you about a minute. Seriously. This is controlled violence in the ring. She is amazing. So anyway, this is Fear Factor. Once again, thank you very much for coming out tonight. And Fear Factor.